us not become desirous of vainglory, provoking one another, envying one another. Brethren, even if a person is caught doing something wrong, you who are spiritually, instruct such a one in a spirit of meekness, considering yourself lest you also be tempted. Bear one another's burdens, and so you will fulfill the law of Christ. For anyone thinks himself to be something, whereas he is nothing, he deceives himself. Let everyone test his own work, and so he will have glory in himself only, and not in comparison with another. For each one will bear his own burden. And let him who is instructed in the word share all good things with his teacher. Be not deceived. God is not mocked. For what a man sows, that he will also reap. For he who sows in the flesh, from the flesh also will reap corruption. But he who sows in the Spirit, from the Spirit will reap life everlasting. And in doing good, let us not grow tired. For in due time we shall reap if we do not relax. Therefore, while we have time, let us do good to all men, but especially to those who are of the household of the faith. Please stand. Continuation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke. That time Jesus went to a town called Nain. His disciples and a large crowd went with him. As he drew near the gate of the town, behold, a dead man was being carried out, the only son of his mother, and she was a widow. And a large gathering from the town was with her. The Lord, seeing her, had compassion on her and said to her, "Do not weep." And he went out and touched the stretcher, and the bearer stood still, and he said, "Young man, I say to you, arise." And he who was dead sat up and began to speak. And he gave it to his mother. Fear seized upon all. They began to glorify God, saying, "A great prophet has risen amongst us, and God has visited his people." Thus far the words of the Holy Gospel. Thank you.